Kanasan sa kanila na po yan, basta't kami ngayon, we I'm saying directly that I have, I believe strongly. Alam nyo, iba yung, we are talking here about bribery.
Yes.
Na sinasabi natin, difficult to prove. Now there is an opportunity for everybody to be enlightened. Why is one water refusing? And I'll go back home, balikan nyo yung mga sinabi ko sa Kongreso. Alam nyo, nagpunta sa akin sila Mr. Rodep. Right after, long hapon no, together with Mr. Joseph. And I told them, I'm very thankful to the Department of Justice, specifically sa mga prosecutors, because they render 24 hour service. At sinasabi ko namin, so that Pideya can be free from this corruption thing, what we do is we immediately file our case, 24 hours on service, and thank you sa prosecutor. So, para hindi na kaming hahabunin ang mga nagsusuhol.
Mr. Chairman, my question is, at that time, when the Pideya said that there was bribery, did they have proof that the prosecutors were really bribed? At that time when the Pideya, because I look at the testimony during the first hearing, and I think there was an allegation by the general that he just made the charge of bribery as a signed warrant in order to attract attention. So my question is, was there proof at that time when the bribery, there was a charge of bribery against his prosecutors for dismissing the charges? Did Pideya have any proof that they were really bribed at that time? Because there was the 800,000 at that time in the account of Rosado, prosecutor Rosado, was not yet exposed. It is only now that it was exposed. So my question again is, did they have proof at that time when the accusation was made that indeed the prosecutors were bribed into dismissing this case?
Again, I would like to emphasize here, Your Honor, Mr. Chairman, that we never accused the prosecutors. You know, una, I will emphasize, sir, kung gagamitin na naman ho yan, I never accused. Ang sinasabi ho na, then this is a primary case where the proofs are very circumstantial, hindi ho proof actually. These are series of incidents where sinabi namin ang umabot na ng 20,000. And we are emphasizing here, na as far as Pideya is concerned, we do not care you bribe anybody for as long as it is not Pideya. Ang sinasabi ko na, ang rule of the game sa Pideya, magsuhol ka na magsuhol, basta hindi ka namin iintindihan, magkoconcentrate kami doon sa case. Yun ang ina-emphasize namin. Kaya nga ang nangyari dito, ang naging point of argument natin, puro bribery, na wala na po yung main issue na nakunan sila nung ang dapat ang binabalikan natin dito is yung aming question na yung aming bang ginawang operation is legitimate or not. Na wala na ho tayo dyan, puro bribery na to. Ang sinasabi ko rito, Mr. Chairman, Your Honor, pumasok ko ang galit ko nito noong tinetrete na si Major Marcelino. Yung cyborg nung parang tumahilip na, and because unang-una, nag-file na yung kaso. Hindi naman nung kami nag-abot. Everything that transpired after is a legal action, not on the part of Pideya anymore. Yun namin ginawa, lahat ng hinihingi namin is based on legal issues na ito ang magagaling na abogado, puro professional itong mga advisor sa likod. Eh alam nilang automatic review process yan. And ang sinasabi ko, bakit I'm surprised that Pideya seems to know what is Memorandum Circular 46, ang Department of Justice parang hindi alam. Pagkatapos ang sinasabi ko, I even forward that according to my lawyers, and I even asked during the hearing, please confirm and help me, kung totoo na po pwedeng i-overturn ng president ng problem, so that pag lumabas ang decision ng Justice Secretary, hindi na tayo magkaroon ng another problem. But again, the Justice Secretary said that the president can overturn, indeed. So, because he is just, sinasabi ko lang ho.
Sir Chairman, may I ask that our source person will just answer, was there bribery at that time? When did they approve at that time when the accusation was made that there was a bribery? I think the answer of the Chairman Pideya is he never accused the DOJ of bribery. So that's all I wanted to know. At that time, there was no bribery, there was no proof of bribery.
Mr. Chairman, may I... Ang sinasabi ko natin dito, I told them, because me,
ikaw, eh, there is insinuation already that money naglaro na ho ang pere. Asa na ho yung group, insinuation ho that Mr. Chairman, Ronald, ding-ding, there is that topic. Ito na ho, ang lead na hinihingi natin eh, and I'm very happy na pumasok na rito sa picture ng AMLAC eh. Because AMLAC will be a player.
May bayan direct, may question sa
Mr. Chairman, just one that. Because the AMLAC came in only, Mr. Chairman, because of this anonymous letter that there is an 800,000 and this was just discovered 2 days ago. At that time, when the accusation of bribery was made, there was still no 800,000. So there was still no, not whatever. That's my point, Mr. Chairman. That's why I was asking.
Mr. Chairman, I think actually, the truth is, wala pong accusation of who was being bribed. But definitely, there was definitely mga divulgence of the bribe attempts and to Major Marcelino himself. And I think that was, and then after that, speculation ako ang nangyari. So there was no real. There was no real accusation as to DOJ being bribed or the prosecutors being bribed. There was more of an air of doubt as to because of the fact that Major Marcelino was offered the bribe. There was already a sort of cloud of doubt that because of the let us say adverse decision that the prosecutor's office came out with, that there are speculations that indeed that the prosecutor's office was bribed. But Mr. Chairman, again, as was said earlier, no, bribe attempts are very difficult to prove, and I think that was the point of Congressman Goles, no, because there's this hanging in the air, this 800,000 that seem to be over and above the usual deposits of Prosecutor Rezado, and I think it is beneficial to all to actually really trace kung saan ang galing itong 800,000, if it is really, because yun na nga, the truth is, and Prosecutor Rezado is right, there is no case of bribe, of bribe, because ngayon nga lang lumabas ito, all of these are just basically doubts.
Mr. Chairman, following up the good points of our colleagues, Congressman Custodio and Congressman Big Bob Quezolodo, may I direct my question to Prosecutor Rezado? Because there was this suggestion that he was not able to reveal what he just revealed about the attempted bribery, this time coming from Medea, dahil hindi na siya nabigyan ng time. And knowing that I was one of those who grilled him, I thought that maybe I'm being alluded to a certain extent. But the question is, anong period ito, Prosecutor Rezado, yung sinasabi mong series of telephone calls coming from Attorney Lazaro? Anong period?
September 21, at saka yung first week po na yan, sumunod.
Okay, so September. Now, of course, your interpretation at that time was it was a bribe attempt, correct? So, ang tanong ko rito, you are a prosecutor. Alam natin, ang prosecutor, isa sa mga pillars of justice together with law enforcement. You are a very responsible public official, a lawyer at that. You were aware that a bribe attempt was made, or...